Welcome to riotcontrol.com. In this video, we'll discuss about what is sprint report in Jira and how to generate a sprint report in Jira. So if you're new to this channel, consider subscribing and pressing bell icon for more updates. So let's understand what you will get it from this video. We'll discuss here what is sprint report in Jira, how to generate sprint report, and how to view detail analysis with practical demo. So without wasting time, let's jump to the Jira login credential where all the projects are listed here. So for generating a sprint report, we have to select any specific board or projects here and navigate to the reports. From here, you will find it out sprint report options. Select that and post that your sprint report will be generated for your particular sprint. Even you can change your sprint from the drop down list to any particular sprint. So let's understand what is sprint report. Sprint report shows the list of issues in each sprint. It is useful for our sprint retrospective meetings and also for mid sprint progress check. If we have a Jira software connected to our Confluence, we can create a retrospective page via the linked pages. So viewing a sprint report is very important part, and understanding these sprint reports is very much helpful when we are analyzing these reports. So if you can see in these three dots, you can reopen sprint report, delete sprint report, and whenever it is required, you can navigate to any of the particular points. And below the lines, you will find it out completed issues and issue not which is not completed in detail sections, which will consist of issue type, priority, status, and story point. You can configure any of the points at any point of time. So let's understand how we can view the sprint report. The sprint report is board specific, that is, will be only included issue that match our board save filter. Issues added after the sprint starts are included within an asterisk. An issue is considered to be to-do when it is in status that has been mapped to the leftmost column of our board. Similarly, an issue is considered to be done when it is in status that has been mapped to the rightmost column of our board. So if you can see in this graph, this is the gray line represents the guidelines, red lines represent remaining values, and the gray out non-working days is listed here. So these are the non-working days in particular sprint. The x-axis shows time and y-axis is representing story points. The gray line is a guideline that is drawn from the total estimates of the issue at the start of the sprints. So this is the gray line. The gray line says that during non-working days. These gray lines showing the non-working days. The red line represents actual work done during the sprint. It's drawn from the total estimates of the issues at the start of the sprint, and it goes higher or lower as our team works on the issue in the sprint. Whenever we are dealing with the red line shows the current total estimates for unresolved issue at any point in the sprint. It also reflects issues that are added or removed from the sprint. If our board is configured to tracking remaining estimates and time spent, a green line will be displayed in the sprint report indicating work logged on an issue. So this is how we can generate a sprint report and analyze our sprint report, which is very much important when we are looking forward to retrospective meeting. So that's all about sprint report in Jira. Hope you liked it. If you really enjoyed the session, consider subscribing. And if you have thinking this is a valuable, consider sharing within your circle. Thank you for watching.